We'll be discussing two basic instructions of PLC, that is relay type of instructions. They are contact instructions. So in those we will be learning XIC, that is examine if closed, and XIO, that is examine if open instruction. These are the input instructions. Among the output instruction, we will be learning energize coil instruction. We begin with the relay type instructions. So these are basically relay type instructions of the PLC. It's the PLC software. In this relay type of instructions, we are going to study contact instructions. And the first contact instruction is examine if closed, that is XIC, or check for one instruction. So this is a contact type of instruction. Presuming that you know the basics of PLC, if this is the PLC and let's assume that this is the input module side and this is the output module side. If at channel number 01, if I am connecting a switch here, just to show a wiring diagram, if it is energized by 24 volts DC, this is a switch which is connected to the input channel I01, and it's a normally open switch. Let's assume that it's a normally open switch. If the switch is open, the 24 volts will not be available at channel number 01, and if the switch is closed, the 24 volts will be available at channel number 01. Let us take the first case, that the switch is open and 24 volts is not available at channel number 01 at this terminal. The PLC has an input image table, that is the memory, it's a data file. So in this memory table, there are spaces, memory spaces, 00 channel, 01 channel, 02 channel, 03 channel, and so on. So now, since there is a 0 volts here, the internal signal conditioning circuit will be converting this 0 volts into a logic 0, and that will be stored in your channel number 01, that is here. So there will be a 0 stored in the input image table of the PLC, that is in the memory of the PLC. If suppose this switch is closed, instead of being open, now if the switch is closed, so if it is closed now, that was position 1, at position 2 now if it is closed, so if the switch is closed, the 24 volts will be available at this channel terminal, that is I01. So the logic circuit inside the PLC input module will convert this 24 volts into logic 1, and in the memory of channel 01, instead of 0, it will now be storing 1. So this is the basics of when we connect a switch. If it is open, it generates a logic 0 in the respective memory space. If it is closed, it generates a logic 1. And this is possible because of the signal conditioning circuit inside the input module. Now suppose we want to use this instruction. So let us take a small PLC program. I am showing a ladder diagram program here, a very small program having input instruction, that is a XIC or a check for one instruction, and here there is a output instruction. This output instruction is energize coil instruction. Let's say I have connected channel number 01, so just having, channel number 01, I have given the address to this instruction, and the output, let me assume that the output channel number 03, I am observing the output, so that's the channel number 03 of the output, and this instruction is the energized coil instruction. As we know that in the ladder diagram, okay, that's the end of the program. First of all, let me just, as we know that if there is a logic continuity in the input side, in the input conditions, then this rung, this logic continuity will energize this particular instruction. So if this instruction is true, there is logic continuity here and this will be energized, that is channel number 03 will be energized. It will store 1 in the output image table. Now let's say if the switch is open, that is position 1, so 0 is reaching here. So in the memory space it has a 0. Now I have drawn here 1, but if it is 0, in that case this instruction is a check for 1 and in the memory you have 0, so this instruction will be false. If the instruction is false, there is no logic continuity, and in the output image table at channel number 03 it will be storing 0 since there is no logic continuity here. So there is a output image table, and in the output image table in the memory space 00010203 channel number, it will store 0. Now here, so since the switch is open, it has stored, since the switch is open, it has stored a 0, or the output 03 channel is de-energized. Now if the switch is closed, it will have a logic 1 in the channel 01. Since channel 01 has a logic 1 and the instruction is check for 1, so this instruction will become true. There is a logic continuity in the input conditions, so the output image table at channel number 03 will store 1. So the new output image table, this is a output image table, it will be storing 1. I can summarize this as, if it is a check for 1 instruction, if it is a check for 1 instruction, and if the switch is open in the memory, it stores a 0. For this particular program, only for this particular program, since it is 0 and the instruction is checked for 1, so the input instruction will be false, and hence the output will be de-energized, or it will store a 0. If the switch is closed, in the memory it will store logic 1. The input instruction, this input instruction will now be true because it is checked for 1 and in the memory it is having 1. So this instruction will be true. There is a logic continuity here, and in channel number 03 of the output it will be energized, that is it will store a logic 1. So the instruction is true and this will be energized, storing a logic 1. This 0 and 1 of the output channel number 03 can be used to connect the output devices such as a relay coil or a motor starter and so on. So this was a XIC instruction. We go for, now we will discuss another contact type of instruction. This is a examine if open or check for 0. For this instruction also the switch conditions remains the same, that is if the switch is open 0 volts and in the memory, that's the input image table, it will be logic 0. If the switch is closed 24 volts and in the logic the memory, it will be storing 1. A small program, let us assume the same switch but now the instruction is different. So the switch we have connected at 01 channel and the output we are observing or using is 03. That's a small program. In this program, now if the switch is closed, let's take if the switch is open and the switch is closed, two conditions. So if the switch is open, as we know that if the switch is open in the memory, in the input image table, in the memory, in the input image table, it stores a zero. So this zero and the instruction is check for zero. So this makes the instruction true, and there is a logic continuity here because it is true and which energizes the channel 03. So if the switch is open in the memory, it stores 0. The input instruction is true because it is checked for 0 and in the memory it has 0. So according to the program, this is true, so output channel number 3 will be energized or storing a 1 in the output image table. Now if the switch is closed, as we know, if the switch is closed, 24 volts is available at the channel, storing a logic 1 in the memory. Since the memory has logic 1 and the instruction is check for 0, but in the memory it is 1, so the instruction will be false. If the instruction is false, there is no logic continuity on this side and therefore channel number 03 will be de-energized. So here, if it is closed in the memory, it is 1, the instruction is false and the output will be de-energized. That is, it will store 0. So this was all about the two instructions, examine if open and examine if closed. The two contact type of instructions. So I think it is clear from this that whenever you want the logic to be, the output to be energized with the switch closed, you have to use this instruction, and whenever you want the output to be high with the switch open, you have to use the XIO instruction.